لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Peace of Allah be upon everybody, Muslims and non-Muslims. My brothers and sisters, this is mashallah. I'm going to speak about three important issues in which I want you to be present inshallah. But before I could start, I want to show you something that what I'm going to talk about inshallah.
How many female imams are there? In the UK at the moment, just because I presume we'll get to this more, but representing, of course, women, which you will do as part of this, how many do we have in Britain?
I mean, I think... are truly representative, so I think that,
you don't know, that's fine if you don't know, but do we have female imams in this country?
I mean, again, it's not... What are you referring... chaplains, or you're referring to women that lead the prayer? What are you referring to? And I think,
well, you tell me. I'm genuinely intrigued to know. Of course, female priests have been around for some time. We've also seen the advent of female rabbis in this country. What is the picture for women leading prayer in Britain in Muslim communities? Because the Muslim Council of Britain's played such an important role in getting the number of Muslims, for instance, added to the census. I mean, that was done at the turn of the turn of the century, so we actually knew how many Muslims there were. Do we have female imams?
I think what the important...
Okay, so all my Muslim brothers and sisters, please watch till the end of this, because this is a question, and many Muslims didn't like it, and they have reported about EmmaBarnett. And our sister Zara, Mohammed, she also tried her best to give the answer, and she wanted to give the answer, but she said that whatever she knew, she just said it, mashallah. So first of all, I would like to congratulate Zara Mohammed that mashallah, you are strong Muslim, mashallah, you are practicing Muslim, and you did your best. As far as my sister in humanity, EmmaBarnett, is concerned, I also agree with her that she, because of her job, she can ask any question she likes, and she can ask to anybody she wants. Yes, that's fine. And also, I have no objection for her asking that, do we have female imams in Islam? And then Sister Zara said, no, I don't know. And then she said, can we have? So Sister Zara also, asked so many things. And also the third thing she said, that can a woman be, imam leading the communities where the men and women are there? For me, I will tell you, this has got two answers for it. First, yes, woman can be imam, but she can only be imam leading the prayers for women only, and that she has to sit in the middle of it. And there are plenty of narrations out there, narrated by, Warqa and Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, and also Salama. So if somebody wants the references, inshallah, what I'm going to do is, in my description, I will give all the full references. So that will be my first thing. Second thing is that, this is my first answer, that yes, we can have Muslim female imams leading the prayers for the women. That's fine, mashallah. So that's the first answer. Second thing, how many? Definitely, I can say that wherever the Muslim community is there, and wherever the Muslim women are there, and if they needed any imam, female imam, to lead the prayer, so that can be like that. So it can be thousands and thousands. So those people who are saying, no, zero, yes, no, zero in this country, because we don't need it. Why zero in this country is the answer for her. A last question, where she is saying that can a Muslim female imam can become the imam for the community where the men and women are there? So that is zero. And those who are doing that, they are also zero in their religious belief. They have no credit in their religion. If they think by themselves that they are Muslims and they can do that, that's fine with them. But the consensus of Islamic conditions and terms and conditions and doctrine, they are not the females who are Muslims, so-called Muslims, leading the mixed gathering of community, and they are calling themselves Muslims. They have nothing to do with Islam. Second thing, I can also say that, can a non-Muslim male be imam for the Muslims? Again, can a non-Muslim male can be imam for the Muslims in the masjid, in the community? We say no, because he is a non-Muslim. To lead the prayer in the community, a person, first thing, he has to be a Muslim. Second thing, can a female be imam in the mixed community where men and women are there? The answer is no. And if she does that, the four school of thoughts, Hanafi school of thoughts, Maliki school of thought, Shafi'i, Hanbali, until today, it is the consensus of all the schools, different schools of thought, that a female cannot be an imam leading a mixed congregation, which means they have men behind them. And if they led and they followed this woman, their prayer is invalid, and she who is leading, her prayer is also invalid. So that's in brief. Now, my advice to my sister, EmmaBarnett, that first of all, as far as her part is concerned, what she should do is that she should ask the person who is authority in Islam. Our sister Zara, mashallah, she is General Secretary of MCB, that is Muslim Council of Britain. So, and she is not authority to make the rulings, yes or no. So, but she tried her best, and congratulations to her. As far as your question is concerned, and many people have refuted you, no, I don't agree with them, because they brought the matter of your father and mother who are running the business, which is not accepted in our religion. So they put that is, you know, those arguments to put you down. I'm not saying that. No, you are, as a journalist, you have the same right to do that. Now, my advice to you, my dear sister, study more about Islam. Study more about our Islamic rules and regulations with the rights that Islam has given to a woman, generally, a mother, a sister, a wife, and a daughter. What Islam has given the right, and all these women are leaders in our Islam. They can be leaders for the men, they can be leaders for the women. And but when it comes to the prayer, as I said, that even a male, but if he is a non-Muslim, he can't lead the prayer. So that's very clear, because we have a terms and conditions who will lead the prayer. And as I said, it is the consensus of all the Muslim scholars and all the different sects in Islam that women cannot lead the congregation where the men and women are together. So that's totally unaccepted. Now, coming back to you, my dear sister, EmmaBarnett, I will advise you that please, because this question has normally comes, you know, this question normally comes from those people who are calling, you know, to equality between men and women. They want men and women to be equal in every aspect of the life. Okay, if that is the case, but where it is there, where it is. Now, as a sister, EmmaBarnett, you are a journalist, you are anchor on TV. Now, you can make a research on that, and if you have that courage, then come in public and tell that where your job as a female doing on TV, and the same person, a male, who is also doing the same job as yours, are you both paid the same? And the answer will be no, whether you accept it or not. Same thing, if you take from the government department till the lower department, any area where male and female are working, okay, in the politics, you'll find the women are sexually, mentally, physically, psychologically. They have been blackmailed, bullied, and they have not given the equal status of the man, whereas work, burden, responsibilities are more. So that is in every angle. Politics, education, hospitals, military, in the army, your media, everywhere. And you, there are plenty of examples are there, and I don't have to even say that. Even generally, you know that pay gap, that will give you an idea. So I'm just only talking about pay gap. No, there are people, there are the women in different, federations, organizations, institutes. Women are sexually, mentally, physically, and psychologically blackmailed, bullied, and they are not given equal right, whereas the work and the burden and responsibility are more. And then we go back to the sports now. We can see in football, men footballers and female footballers are not equally respected and not equally, you know, paid. Boxers, bodybuilders, tennis players, all these people in the cricket, all different places. I'm not saying whether they are halal or haram in Islam, but I'm telling you, my sister, EmmaBarnett, please do research, do the research on these areas and bring the rights of the woman there and talk about it. And plus, because you are not a Muslim, still you will object. My question to you, why you want to know whether the Muslim female can become Imam? Do you want to become Imam for us? Answer will be no, because of two reasons. Because you are non-Muslim, we will not let you. Even for our Muslim women, you cannot be our Imam. You cannot lead their prayers because you are non-Muslim. Second thing, if you want to lead the prayer for men, you are not allowed because that's a consensus in our religion. So, and as I said, that even non-Muslim would want to lead the prayer, he cannot. Now, coming back to my brothers and sisters, first of all, let me tell you, the beginning of my show, there was an ayah which I read from chapter 33, verse 27. It says that for us, the role model is لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ وَسُوَةٌ حَسَنًا. For us, as Muslims, Islam is the religion, Quran is the book to follow, and practically we follow the example of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So from these three sources, I will explain to you. In Surah Ali Imran, chapter 3, verse 18, Allah SWT, verse 80 and 83, all these verses Allah speaks there. Very clearly Allah says, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ الْخَاسِرِينَ. That anybody who is trying to practice Islam other than from the teaching of the Quran, anything that is in the name of religion, practice other than which is there in the Quran and the teaching of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Allah will not accept it, and that person is a loser. To our context, women leading the prayer for the man, thinking that she will be rewarded, this ayah confirms that her act will not be accepted. She will be the most and the biggest loser on the Day of Judgment. She can be very happy in this world. Second thing, our Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has clearly said that the Quran says, وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whatever you get from Rasul, take it, and whatever he says, don't do it, don't do it. Okay, then the third ayah, it says, فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِ أَنْ تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةٌ أَوْ يُصِيبَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Those people who are going against the teaching of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they should be warned of two things. First, they will be falling into afflictions, tribulations, and confusions and doubts. And the second thing, even if they don't stop themselves from these divisions and confusions and disputes, then they should wait for the final punishment, which will be a severe punishment from Allah. So this is the final thing. Then when it comes to the religion, the source is Quran and the Sunnah. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu atti'u Allah wa atti'u Rasulah, the whole big verse from chapter 4, verse 59. Allah made it very clear, we have to follow Quran and Sunnah, and we have to follow the Muslim authorities. And if the Muslim authorities dispute, then we have to again verify it from Quran and Sunnah. We have to go back to Quran and Sunnah. So same thing, very clearly mentions that the Quran does not say about the woman to lead the prayer. And Quran, Hadith does not say, the teaching of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam does not say that she can be the imam. Okay, then coming back to final thing, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِن. This is لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. This is a very strong verse in Surah Nisa again, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had made it very clear. This is chapter 4, verse 65. Allah made it very clear that those people who are, after listening the final judgment from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when they are disputed, if they don't follow him, don't accept him, then they are out of the fold of Islam. So good luck to them. Now coming back to the whole system, do we have imams? Female imams in our religion? Yes, we have female imams in our religion, and we have the evidence from Sunan Abu Dawud. This is our traditional book of hadith, and the hadith number is 591-592. Similar hadith is reported in Musnad Imam Ahmad. Similar hadith is mentioned in Musannaf ibn Abdul Razak and Musannaf ibn Abi Shayba. These are the books, classical books we have in Mustadrak Hakim. And all these ahadith, they confirm that there was a lady, aged lady, she had learned the Quran, and she came to Rasulullah, visited her house, and Rasulullah, you know, she requested him to appoint one muadhin who can give the call to prayer, and she would lead the prayer. And the narrations is very clear that she was leading the prayer of the family of her member, the members of her family, means members in her family in the house, and not from the outside, and not the community. Those people who have said that this hadith says that she was an imam for the community, they are lying upon Rasulullah. Either they should go and study again properly, or they should say tawbah to Allah, they should make tawbah to Allah, and they should say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah again, because according to me, knowingly if they say that, then they are out of the fold of Islam. Because this hadith does not say she was an imam for the mixed community. No, she was the imam for the family members of her house. And the only the one who was giving the adhan was also an aged man, old man, who could not lead the prayer. So even that does not, you know, clearly says that she was, while she was leading the prayer, he was with them or behind them. No narration. So we can't put these things in our, you know, when we are making a ruling, we are not allowed to add things into that. Then we see that from the very beginning of Rasulullah's life, he lived as a prophet for 23 years. And from the first day, Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq, the day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran to him through the angel Jibreel, he started praying. And then the first woman in Islam was Khadija. She started praying with him, and she was behind him. Then the first man, the young boy who was 10 years old, Ali, his cousin, he became the first Muslim, male Muslim in the time of Rasulullah at the beginning of Islam. And he was also praying with Rasulullah. He was next to him and his wife was behind him. Rasulullah has explained to us how the congregational prayer can be led. And everywhere, wherever the question came, even if it was a young person leading the prayer, still that young person has to be a male. And we have lots of evidence to that. If there are two males, one female, one male will be standing next to the imam and the women will be behind. If even the family members, we have the hadith in Sahih Bukhari from Anas bin Malik that Rasulullah visited his house, and he made, because the women were aged women, so he made a special place for them in the house to lead the prayer. And Anas bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala is saying that Rasulullah once came to our house, he led the prayer with us, for us. So he said that Prophet was in front of me, and I with another man, where we were behind him, and our ladies were behind the men. So this is very clear. In our religion, we don't have that. And till his last breath, when he was in the last stage of his life, he was dying. And at that time, he was in the house of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she was imam leading the women. Umm Salima, she was imam, she was leading the women. And also other, this Umm Warqa, she was an imam, she was leading the women. All these three women were leading, and they were imams, female imams leading the prayers, but they were leading the prayers only for the women, and they were also leading the fard prayers. This is very clear from our narrations, our traditions. So my sister, EmmaBarnett, I have answered your question from Quranic perspective, from Hadith perspective. Now I will tell you, in Islam, when we talk about, as I gave you the homework, go and search for the rights, equal rights of the women in the politics, go and search the equal rights of the women in the army, go and search the equal rights of the women in the hospitals, where the doctors and nurses are working together, male and female. Go and search for that. Also, go and search for the rights of the women in the education, which is a noble job and, you know, pure and clean job to educate the humanity. Go and search for that. And then if you think, and in your own career where you are as a journalist and anchor, you see what do the women have the right or not. Now let's come to our Islamic understanding with regards to the human rights, because we are Muslims and we follow Allah's religion. And if we are those people who are saying that they are Muslims only by name, and they want to follow what they think logically and what goes into their hearts, and something which they think to the according to the modernist people, think more modernist thinking, if they think that no, women should be equal, okay, let's see what Quran says. If they are Muslims, they should go by this ayah. And this is from chapter 4, verse 32. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, and I want to read this in Arabic so that inshallah, those people who ears are open, mind has, you know, clearly no insanity is there, and they are sound in mind. Let's see what Allah says in the Quran is for all of them. And for my sister, EmmaBarnett, you have to study more about it. So the Quran says, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَلَا تَتَمَنَّوْا مَا فَضَّلَ اللَّهُ بِهِ بَعْضَكُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ لِلرِّجَالِ نَصِيبٌ مِّمَّا اكْتَسَبُوا وَلِلنِّسَاءِ نَصِيبٌ مِّمَّا اكْتَسَبْنَا وَاسْأَلُوا اللَّهَ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمًا. That وَلَا تَتَمَنَّوا مَا فَضَّلَ اللَّهُ بِبَعْضَكُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ. And wish not for the things in which Allah has made some of you to excel others. For men there is a reward for what they have earned, and likewise for women there is reward for what they have earned. And ask Allah for His bounty. Surely Allah is ever all-knower of everything. Chapter 4, verse 32. This is very clear, my brothers and sisters. Quran says that you should not, you know, a man should not wish to be woman, and women should not wish to be a man, and they should not wish to be equal in their responsibilities. Our women, mashallah, they can be doctors, and they can lead to the highest level of the doctor. All the junior doctors can be following that, and she can be the leader of the medical doctors. She can be leader of the head of the school. She can be leader of, you know, any organization. And she is asking, how many imams are there, female imams? Go and shake our Islamic madrasas. All these, mashallah, young Muslim female students who are learning the religion and coming out with the graduation as scholars, these are our imams. These are female imams for the women. Wherever the women are needed to lead the prayer for women, these are all the madrasas, mashallah. You're talking about, you won't be able to count. You'll get tired while counting them. So we have imams. Let me conclude now finally, my brothers and sisters. And Quran seriously warns that knowingly, if you go against the teaching of Allah and His Rasul, you are challenging Allah. So wait for Allah's punishment, because you are challenging Allah. You are raising war against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let's conclude this. Do we have female imams? Yes, we have. Can women, you know, be imam? Women can be imam in the prayers? Yes, she can be imam in the prayer. Okay, can they lead the congregation, mixed congregation? No, in our religion, it is not allowed. Why? Well, just one point I'm telling you, because first of all, it is Allah's command, and the life of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, 23 years, he did not allow this thing. Third, the final thing, why Islam is so strict about this. Now, as my sister, she will know. I'm going to just tell you one thing. When the people have met their own human, man-made system, and when they have tried to give their equal rights to the women in all these different fields where she is working, subhanAllah, I have seen that psychologically they are tortured, mentally they are tortured, and not only that, sexually they are blackmailed. Sexually they are blackmailed. So she will know, as an anchor, she will know how many women are standing for abortions. How many women are giving birth to the illegitimate children. Why? This is because, and unfortunately, we know there are students who are, you know, selling their bodies because this has, you know, for job of the, or the like profession of prostitute is made so open that this, the girls who are, you know, in need to complete their educations, they go into this business. SubhanAllah, this is not something which is not allowed. And when a person is going to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he should be worshipping, you know, concentrating and devoting his prayers to God. Bowing, prostrating, and remembering that you are standing in front of God. And when you have a mixing of the woman there, how can you concentrate? And can a woman, subhanAllah, we have enough when women went into mixing, what happened to them? That's enough is enough. We don't want that corruptions. We don't want that, you know, garbage and dirt and filth coming in our masjid mixing like this. Because today, maybe somebody will say, no, we are very safe here. We are praying. But this is how gradually every field, when they start, they are clean. Later on, the dirt and filth come in that. And my sister, EmmaBarnett, you cannot deny that. And if you think that you need somebody to debate you, then please, I'm ready here. I'm Dr. Abdul Majid, well known in the public and well known in the media. Invite me on your show and we'll discuss, because I respect you. And I say you have the full right to ask, question anything. But when you ask for the equality, then you have to prove me where women in the Western world or any part of the world where women are given equal right in any field. And then we can talk about the equal right of mother, wife, daughter and sister in Islam, inshallah. Barakallah fiqh. I think I have conveyed my message to all of you. Jazakumullah khairan, my brothers and sisters. If you have got any other questions, you are most welcome to put your questions on the description or in the comments. Jazakumullah khairan. My sister, EmmaBarnett, God bless you and keep you safe from all the harm that could come to you. And my sister Zara Muhammad, congratulations for your masha position. May Allah keep you firm. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر لمن